I would say that Ryuichi Tamura is a poet unrivaled in the power of his words and his unique rhythm. The words of his poems come from ancient times and pierce the heart deeply. The words of his poems have been around since time immemorial, and they pierce deeply into the heart. The Way Home, Ryuichi Tamura. I should never have learned the words. A world without words. If I had lived in a world where words didn't mean anything, how much better it would have been. Even if you are avenged by a beautiful word, I don't care about that. When you shed your blood for silent meaning, it has nothing to do with me. The tears in your gentle eyes, the pain that falls from your silent tongue. If there were no words in our world, I'd just look at it and walk away. Are your tears as meaningful as a kernel of fruit? In a drop of your blood, in the dusk of this world, does it have the crack of a shivering sunset? I shouldn't have learned any language thanks to the fact that I've learned Japanese and a few foreign languages. I stand still in your tears. I'll come back alone in your blood. The Invisible Tree, by Ryuichi Tamura. There were footprints in the snow. For the first time I saw the footprints. I saw for the first time a world dominated by small animals, birds, and creatures of the forest. I saw a world dominated by small animals, birds, and creatures of the forest. For example, there was a squirrel. The footprints came down from an old elm tree across the path and disappeared into the fir forest. There was no momentary hesitation, no anxiety, no witty question mark. Just another fox. His footprints followed the path along the valley to the north of the village. His footprints follow the path along the valley to the north of the village in a straight line. The hunger I know, the hunger I knew never drew such a straight line. The elastic, blind, positive rhythm of these footprints was never in my mind. For example, a small bird. A footprint more transparent than its voice claw marks, more piercing than its life. Her feathers knotted on the snowy slope. The fear that I know I've never seen such a single pattern fleshly. Heretical, positive rhythms like these feather marks I've never had in my mind. Suddenly, there's a big sunset at the top of Mount Asama. Something creates a forest. The mouth of the valley widens, tearing at the cold air. I go back to my hut. I turn on the stove. I turn on the stove. Invisible trees, invisible birds, invisible little animals. I am. I keep thinking about invisible rhythms translated with